Hello and welcome. Arrow Knight here. Today, we're going to chat about the Black Armory and my thoughts so far. Spoiler warning, if you haven't played any of it yet and don't want to be spoiled, the background footage is all probably going to be Black Armory content, and also I'll be discussing it in detail as well. I decided to hold off on my recent video topic. I did a Twitter poll and let you guys vote, and we were going to talk about PvP sandbox tuning, but with the release of Black Armory, I figured we would go ahead and chat about it this reset, and then next reset, we'll return to normal form with the topic PvP sandbox tuning. I do usually like to post each week a Twitter poll with a few topics for you guys to vote on. So if you're interested in voting on that, I normally do that each week. So just follow me on Twitter at @ArrowKnight with a zero, A-E-R-0, K-N-I-G-H-T, and vote and let me know what you guys want to see. Of course, other topic ideas are always welcome as well. If you do enjoy this video, a like is very much appreciated. And if you're new to the channel and find that you were entertained, be sure to subscribe. As always, thanks so much for all the support, guys. Now let's jump in. The Black Armory launch. I've been taking in all the community's feedback the last couple days, and I have so many thoughts. Let's go over some of the feedback I've been seeing, and I'll sprinkle in my thoughts as well. It's always easier to go over the complaints, in quotes, as those guardians are who we hear from pretty quick. That's not necessarily a bad thing. Their feedback and opinion is very important, but naturally people tend to vocalize their distaste for something quicker than their liking of it. Sometimes it'd be nice to get a balance of the two more often, but hey, we're only human. Now, I must say, when visiting the Destiny of the Game Reddit this week, I did see these complaint posts, but also just as many content posts. So it doesn't seem like the community as a whole is too overly displeased with the Black Armory launch. The main item that will lead into everything else is that there is not enough new content, mainly due to power level requirements. We've seen it said and posted quite a bit already, just in the few days that Black Armory has been out. There isn't enough accessible, that's the key word, new content with the launch of the first tier of the Black Armory and Annual Pass structure. Upon logging in, you can check out my video from earlier this week too. I did throw up a video just with my initial first log on and what you experience in the first, 15 minutes of getting into Black Armory. But anyways, upon logging in, you visit Spider for some dialogue, a quest then to visit the tower for a nice cutscene and to meet our new Black Armory vendor, Ada One. She then sends you on a multi-tiered quest to kill many aliens. And most of this is done or can be done quickly in previous content patrol zones, then sending you to the new forge activity. This is where it stops for a lot of guardians. The new Volunder Forge has three levels. Tier 1, 610 power level. Tier 2, 625 power level. Then Tier 3, 630 power level. From what I've seen, it is very difficult to complete at 600 power level even, as we've seen in a lot of coverage and heard from many guardians. I've heard it gets a bit easier as you hit about the 607 range and above, but I plan on jumping into it here soon. I actually did some power grinding last night, and after getting multiple drops, I'm only at 601, but I plan on jumping in there and giving it a go here soon. So my thoughts on this. I do understand where Guardians are coming from. In the past, we've been used to getting a decent chunk of new content to sift through before the main grind begins. At the same time, which would you rather have? New content that you chew up and spit out quickly with nothing to do after that, or content that is a bit out of reach, allowing for more to do later on? I think there is a happy middle ground here. With the launch of the first part of the first tier of the annual pass, that's a mouthful. Basically, what I mean is we're kind of in the first little tier section of the first new content drop with more weeks to come and then more to come in future seasons. So we're kind of like at the very beginning of it all, if you will. I think it may have been a bit smoother if the power level wall wasn't immediate on this very first initial drop. Now, many have suggested that the first forge be at around 600 power level so that there's new content that we can grind right away. I think there is some merit to that, but I also want stuff to do after the first week and weeks to come. Let's take a moment to look at Bungie's pretty graphic they made for us when communicating how the season of the Forge was going to pan out. I nerd out on UI and graphical stuff, so I dig this image. It's pretty. Black Armory begins, as we know, it did begin, on December 4th. We got our first forge, then another forge right away on December 7th, and then the new raid on the 7th as well. Then the dawning on the 11th, another forge on the 18th, Niobe Labs, we're not sure what this is, on January 8th, an exotic quest on January 29th, then ending the season with Crimson Days on February 5th. This is the new content structure for Destiny. This is what they communicated to us. This looks great to me. I'm sure it does to many Guardians. New things to do pretty regularly. Now, between December 8th to January 8th, then again from January 8th to January 29th, those are pretty big gaps. I hope there's been enough new content added at the hobbyist level to keep us coming back until the next season. But this is the new content structure. We also do have other things to chase. Titles, pinnacle weapons, builds to work on, random rolls, and on and on. Again, this is the new content structure. There isn't a big in-between expansion like Warmind to play at our own pace or until you have nothing to do anymore, lasting many months until the next DLC release. I think this, being the annual pass structure, may be a bit jarring for both us and Bungie to initially dive into. I think they are learning as we are, like we have been doing since the Destiny Alpha launched. This is new territory. It's not that they don't know their game or they still haven't figured their own game out. I see that comment quite a bit. It's that they are best trying to understand how we want to play their game and consume it, combined with the vision of what we all want Destiny to be for many different types of players. So many different ways that they play it. The Bungie team are the players too. They play this game. We know that. This is the first content drop with this new structure implemented. As always, it is important we provide respectful, constructive feedback because that will better the overall experience. It's all just a part of the process. So that's the important part, you know, keep it constructive, keep it respectful. Back to my thoughts on the topic at hand. I think we've learned that yes, maybe this introductory forge could have had an easier tier to start with, then we get access to a more difficult version of it. Then each forge released after that throughout the season is the more difficult version. Then Guardians could experience it a bit more before hitting that power level wall. Or I saw this awesome idea somewhere, I think maybe it was on Reddit, sorry I can't give you a shout out Guardian, but the idea was, what if we could have started to grind this new 650 power level max last week, last reset, when the season of the Forge technically launched with patch 2.1.0. I think this may have been a great solution for these concerned Guardians. All of us, really, we could have started this power level grind last week. It's not like we would have gotten too far, maybe 610. You know, I'm sure Guardians are higher than that. We've learned that the Last Wish raid drops power level items over 600. I'm not sure what max a Guardian has gotten to at this point, but still, it would have been possibly a good thing to start that power level grind a week sooner. Especially with the tweaks we've seen to the power level grind, it takes longer to hit max level. The other issue is that 801's bounties and other items are not available until you complete this first forge. That amplified the opinions and feelings that there is nothing to do upon logging in with this new content. I think these things, of course, may be something Bungie can even adjust soon with a future patch. Overall, the current state of this new content is that you have to grind a bit of old, in quotes, content before you can be effective in the new Forge activity. I understand the complaints and acknowledge some tweaks that may be better, but overall, I'm okay with even the current state for this initial launch. The old content that I refer to isn't really old content anymore, or at least to me and I think many Guardians, nor do I think it is supposed to be considered this with the new structure of Destiny. I love doing my weekly reset leveling up, chasing titles and pinnacle weapons. The structure of Destiny has changed. Visiting Mars well after Mars released is a normal thing now. It's not the classic, this is an old place that I don't have to go to anymore mentality. There are many things in the game that cater to the hobbyist. I've been spending the last few weeks running EP, grinding for the Wayfarer title, and having an absolute blast. I just hit 600 a few resets ago, and the power level grind for me was spot on. Now, we always want more to do, so the feedback from the community does make sense, especially, you know, with it being a new content drop. This concern of the community is very important for the initial launch of the annual pass type of content, but the more important thing to me, and I think to many, is that we have stuff to do all season long. I think that was probably Bungie's main focus on this initial launch, and they are seeing that maybe a little tweak to the power level and vendor stuff with this first drop is an understandable idea. Another thing I wanted to touch base on before signing off, I see a lot of Guardians mentioning that many players aren't even close to 600 power level yet. They either are still grinding due to their free time to play, or they just stopped playing at a certain point altogether. These two things are pretty different to me. If you quit playing at 560 power level for whatever reason, then yes, you certainly will have some grinding to do before you can attempt the Black Armory stuff, the new content. Even if Bungie tweaks it and makes it a little less to do the Forge, maybe 600 to start, you're still going to have some grinding to do. You're not 600. You know, you didn't fully max out with the Forsaken expansion, if you will. If you stop playing, of course, when returning, you aren't going to be ready for the new, more challenging content, especially not with this new structure. There are other things for them to do while they grind power level, though, including chasing pinnacle weapons, climbing the PvP ranks, etc. They also have previous Forsaken content that they probably haven't gotten to yet. I haven't even done the Shattered Throne yet. I don't have the Wishender. These are all things in my to-do list. There are guardians everywhere still enjoying this previously released content. I've been grinding EP solo and have hardly ever ran into a patrol space that wasn't pretty easy to get a run going. The other example is the guardian who has been playing but just doesn't have enough free time to quite hit 600 yet, or it's taken him a while. I'm closer to that guardian probably than the guardian that hit max quick. Like I said, I just hit 600 a few resets ago, and I play pretty regularly. The conclusion isn't really that different though. This guardian still has plenty of content, and they probably haven't completed everything yet that was in Forsaken, and now they have even more to look forward to once they get to that point. Overall, I think the goal is that there is always something for us to do in Destiny now. Bungie is hitting that mark, starting with Warmind and especially since Forsaken. Now with the new annual pass structure, Bungie and the community will continue to learn together how we dish this new structure of content out. This is all new ground for us, Bungie and the community. Sure, Bungie tested the new content, but they never know for sure till they release it to us to consume. Their goal, just like ours, is for Destiny to be the best it can be. Let's not be too quick to forget how much fun we've been having the past many months. Also, just a quick mention, who knows how many possible secret things to uncover are inside of this season. They have been leaning back towards this type of content pretty heavy, as the community said they loved it. We already have a mysterious exotic quest item you can pick up around the forge area that seems as though it's going to take a bit to complete. There's multiple steps. We've also learned that when you forge the new legendary machine gun in your first forge run, that when looking through its sights, ADS, in the Volunder Forge, it allows you to see emblems and other things. Nothing figured out yet, I don't believe, on this, but very interesting stuff. Not sure if this and the quest are related to each other at this point, but hopefully there's more of this secret stuff to come throughout the season. Lastly, just a couple little things. Mod components. They can be purchased at 801. I'm so pumped about this. I loved that we got direct path options with Masterwork cores, aka enhancement cores, but mod components were still very scarce for me. I'm curious if they are for you guys. Did you get many mod components before the Black Armory? Let me know in the comments. I was maybe getting one a week. Now we have a direct path to acquire them. I do hope that the cost still keeps them somewhat scarce. I'm not trying to contradict myself, but like I said many times, I do love that buying mods is a big choice because you don't have a ton of mod components. But getting maybe one a week like I was really rough trying to work on builds and stuff. That's part of the hobbyist endgame, right? Builds, etc. Anyways, just like everything else we've chatted about, we'll see how it pans out in the weeks to come. It's a delicate balance. Overall, I'm having a blast in Destiny right now. I do like to mention my reset so far as well. I've been grinding away at the Wayfarer title, tons and tons of Escalation Protocol, but I just finished up all that loot just this reset. I got all the weapons, I got all the armor, and now I just have a few more things before I can get that crispy Wayfarer title. I've been really enjoying chasing these titles. It's super fun. I love to go into my Triumph, see what I need, and go do that thing. Of course, there's a little bit of RNG in there. You know, we've talked about that on the podcast, but, you know, we'll go with it. I'm not sure which one will be in my list next. Of course, I'm working towards Unbroken, but that one's going to take a little while with all the PvP requirements in that one. But I'll probably pick up another to chase. Maybe the Black Armory one, the Blacksmith. I'm also about to start my grind for the Breakneck Gambit Pinnacle Weapon. Then I'll probably move to the Mountaintop in PvP after that. Anyways, guys, let me know what you've been up to. As always, be sure to comment below and let me know your thoughts on anything I covered in this video. What are your thoughts on the Black Armory, the launch? What has your experience been like so far? What do you think Bungie should do regarding maybe tweaking some things on how this content launched? What other ideas do you have for Bungie on this topic or the community? What do you recommend, you know, some feedback for the community? Also, don't hesitate to send me any other topics you'd like to see me cover. Thank you all so much for tuning in. Again, if you enjoyed the video, a like is very much appreciated. And if you're new to the channel and find that you were entertained, be sure to subscribe. As always, you can find all my info below. Thanks so much for all the support, guys. And until next time, take care.